With Media Day completed earlier this week, we can all sit back, relax, look forward to preseason starting Friday, September 28th. While the Jimmy Butler tree can happen anytime now, depending where he ends up, if it's a bad team, his presence will allow them to instantly improve, especially if he goes back to the Eastern Conference. How's it going, guys? My name's Wilson. As we can't wait to see which teams will shock the world, improving out of nowhere, while others like the Cavs and Timberwolves will likely regress. This past free agency, with certain players going to different teams, will have a strong impact on their team's success. Here are four NBA teams who will drastically improve in the 2018-19 season, starting with the Dallas Mavericks. After being one of the worst teams last season, tied with the third worst record in the league, going 24-58, losing more than 50 games for the first time in 20 years. But not to worry, Mavs fans, even though the team doesn't seem like it'll make the playoffs, they might possibly sneak in as an 8th seed in the tough Western Conference. You know Mark Cuban will try to do everything in his power to send Dirk Nowitzki the best farewell possible, as this will likely be his final season. Cuban was heavily fined $600,000 by the league for his tanking comments he made in the middle of last season. Not afraid to speak his mind, the roster has drastically improved, where last season, rookie Dennis Smith, Yogi Ferrell, Wesley Matthews, Harrison Barnes, and Nowitzki were their starters. Even power forward Maxime Kleber, who most of you probably never even heard of, started 36 games, averaged 5.4 points. With the addition of rookie sensation Luka Doncic and former All-Star DeAndre Jordan, Dallas will be looking to compete each and every night. Doncic, who has the potential to become a future superstar with his amazing basketball IQ and passing ability at 6'8". He'll have the 40-year-old Dirk as a mentor, perhaps handing over the keys from one transcendent European talent to the next. Crazy to say, Dirk started his NBA career before Luka was even born. Unselfishly enough, Nowitzki agreed to come off the bench, doing what's best for the team, allowing DJ to be the starting center, with Luka as the playmaking power forward, setting up glimpses of Lob City, as Harrison Barnes will be their go-to scoring option, putting up 20 points a game. Luka's presence simply will make everybody's job easier, as Dennis Smith won't have to handle the ball too much, will at least be more efficient with a better playmaker on his team. The franchise will only go uphill from here, perhaps improved by 10 wins at the very least. Dallas will simply not be a cakewalk for the Western Conference powerhouses. I predict the Mavs will finish around 500. Number 3, the Chicago Bulls. There is every right to be optimistic for Bulls fans. After finishing with a 27-55 record, and now fully healthy with a solid roster, it's pretty obvious by now. The Bulls easily won that Jimmy Butler trade, as the Timberwolves are in a disastrous situation, giving up Chris Dunn, who has all defensive team potential, putting up 13.5 points along with 2 steals. Zach LaVine, who's been putting in the work in the offseason, is set to have a breakout year, perhaps average over 22 a game. Jabari Parker will look to get a fresh start. Just 2 seasons ago, average over 20 points, has all-star potential. Second year power forward Lauri Markkanen, who was also included in the Jimmy Butler deal, was one of the most promising rookies, put up over 15 points, 7.5 rebounds, a deadly 3-point shooter. And don't forget about Wendell Carter, the 7th overall pick in the 2018 draft, an energy type player who does all the little things, similar to Al Horford. Perhaps the most underrated starting 5 in the NBA, a bunch of the Bulls' current starters has a chance to be future all-stars. I can see Chicago winning 44 games, being the 7th seed in the East, and grow from there. The future is bright in the Windy City. Number 2, the Memphis Grizzlies. After a disastrous 2017-18 season, finishing with the second worst record at 22-60, just a win better than Phoenix, 24 total players suited up getting playing time. As starting point guard Mike Conley only played 12 games, has season-ending surgery on his left heel, ending their playoff chances. It just shows how underrated Conley is, as the soon-to-be 31-year-old point guard is one of the most underappreciated players in the game. Last season, their starting lineup consists of Tariq Evans, Dylan Brooks, Andrew Harrison, Jarrell Martin, and Marc Gasol. Now with Conley back, the additions of Kyle Anderson and rookie Jared Jackson Jr. will look to be instant contributors, especially Jackson with his ability to play both ends of the floor and be a stretch 5 at times. Former second round pick Dylan Brooks averaged 11 points last season, proved to be a solid player, contributing 1,000 times way more than Chandler Parsons ever did with Memphis. If Parsons ever gets fully healthy, he can put up points at the very least, something the Grizzlies were expecting him to do. Even though the grit and grind days are over, Memphis don't have a first round pick in 2019, so they'll go all out, leaving everything on the line. I do expect the team to win at least 38 games, 16 wins better than the previous season. Number 1. The Los Angeles Lakers. LeBron James joining purple and gold was the biggest story of the 2018 free agency, as James has proven throughout his career, he can drag mediocre teams far in the playoffs. The Lakers, with their young talent, shown a lot of promise last season, winning 35 games. Even without James, LA was gonna keep improving, maybe sneak into the playoffs as a 7 or 8 seed if LBJ decided to go elsewhere. But all eyes will be on Los Angeles, as Lonzo Ball will look to have a breakout year and improve on his jumper, while Brandon Ingram, who just turned 21 years old, averaged 16 points a game last season, is capable of being a 20 plus point scorer. The new additions of Rajon Rondo, Lance Stevenson, Michael Beasley, and JaVale McGee will be must-watch television. The steal of last year's draft, Kyle Kuzma, spent the summer working out with Kobe Bryant, who will look to elevate his game to another level. I'm expecting the Lakers to finish anywhere between 50 to 55 wins, with James as a high MVP candidate. The team might not dominate right away. It'll take some time, especially with the chemistry. Which teams do you guys think will have the biggest improvement in the 2018-19 season? How far will LeBron lead the Lakers in his first season with purple and gold? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this video. I talk NBA comparisons, amazing storylines, NBA history, and anything basketball that will interest you. If you love the NBA, subscribe to my channel. More great stuff coming soon. See you next time.